Oscilloscopes are very important instruments used by engineers to develop and debug electronic systems. TI's 3 GHz BUF802 high input impedance buffer has been specifically designed to help designers achieve high signal throughput and reduce system complexity in oscilloscopes, active probes, and data acquisition systems. The BUF802 is a FET-input high input impedance buffer capable of supporting large signal bandwidths of up to 3 GHz and a slew rate of 7,000 volts per microsecond. It provides a single-chip alternative to both ASIC and FET-input amplifier-based front-end designs while providing an input impedance of 50 gigohms and 2.4 picofarads. The device also can be used to achieve an industry-leading dynamic range at a fraction of the cost of ASICs, with distortion better than negative 41 dBc at 2 GHz. The BUF802 is also capable of driving high loads down to 50 ohms without the need of any additional circuitry. The device also supports a wide supply voltage range of plus minus 4.5 volts to plus minus 6.5 volts. The small 3mm by 3mm package alleviates size concerns in space-constrained active oscilloscope probe designs. There is an evaluation board available for the BUF802 to help designers quickly get started with development. The board is set up to support both Mode A, buffer mode, and Mode B, composite loop mode, operating configurations for the BUF802. The bottom portion of the board is for operating Mode A, where the low frequency and high frequency signal components recombine at the input of the device. The top portion of the board is for operating Mode B, where the auxiliary signal path and the main part are used to control the output voltage. Before Mode B can be used, a quick calibration must be performed on the board. The first step is to power the device with a plus 6 volt and minus 6 volt supply using the VCC1, VEE1 connections on the top of the board. The ground connection should also be connected to the ground 1 connector. After the board is powered, then a 1 volt DC signal should be connected to the in SMA connector. Then the signal at the out SMA connector should be monitored as the R6 potentiometer is adjusted. The potentiometer should be adjusted until the signal at the out SMA connector is 1 volt. After this procedure is complete, the BUF802 evaluation board can be used. This procedure is not necessary to use the board for Mode A or buffer mode. To use Mode A, a positive supply, ground, and negative supply should be connected to the VCC2, ground 2, and VEE connectors at the bottom of the board. Then an input can be applied at the in SMA connector, and the output can be observed on the out SMA connector. There is also an oscilloscope reference design featuring the BUF802 used as a high input impedance buffer for the system. This reference design highlights a complete TI-based analog front-end solution from the input buffer to the analog-to-digital converter. Techniques on minimizing error to achieve optimal system signal-to-noise ratio, dynamic range, and ADC e-knob performance is covered in this reference design. The full reference design, including schematics and system performance results, can be downloaded from the link below. More information about the BUF802, including the device datasheet and evaluation board ordering information, can be downloaded at the link below.